see if it works.
Ready?
Meditation always works. The bell in round one on the way. Southpaw stance for Maeda.
Good job.
Oh boy. We know who's gonna strike, and that would be Maeda.
There's a blocked head kick. Yep, the left head kick a la Mirko Krokop blocked, and there was a kick that was blocked. But Frank, you know, against Kung Lee, sometimes when you block a kick, doesn't mean that it's the best thing. You saw an open arm takedown by Fernandez.
Sometimes you need two hands, and sometimes you just need to let it go.
This is really bad for Maeda right now. You have a guy like this, Bibiano Fernandez, on your back. Probably going to want to sweep that left leg over and get both hooks in, and then sit there and ride it out and bash him away until he gives up his neck.
It's a tough position to be in, no doubt about it. But look at the size of those gloves. You know, it's hard to get a big glove like that underneath the chin. If you can get a good grip on that glove or get a block on it, a choke like that's tough to get.
1 minute, change gone here in the opening round. 4 submission wins for Fernandez out of his 12th career victory. Scramble by Ida, and there's the grip in the mound, and looking for that rear naked choke is Fernandez. Maeda has been submitted 3 times in his career. And he escapes this time.
Nothing but nonstop scrambles and a slam.
Powerbomb slam by Maeda. One of the best finishes in Japanese history. Quinton Rampage Jackson on Ricardo Arona. And there's some hammer fist from Maeda, who is being choked here by Fernandez. The triangle choke attempt by Fernandez. Maeda refuses to tap. He's out cold. And Fernandez picks up the first round submission win via triangle choke as he put Yoshiro Maeda to sleep. So Bibiano Fernandez improves to 13-3 with his 5th career victory via tap out. And he's now riding a 5-fight win streak into 2013.
And that, my friend, is the power of the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Man. He
totally relaxed. I mean, once he got the back, and there was so much scrambling, and Maeda actually was doing something really good. He was smashing away, and I'll tell you, Bibiano took some shots.
He took some shots, but the moment he saw a hip opening, he popped his hip out, swung around to his back, was back in choke position before Maeda could do anything about it.
Dream Bantamweight champion Bibiano Fernandez improves to 9-1 under the Dream banner here at Dream 18 New Year's Eve at the storied Saitama Super Arena in Japan.
Well, I've been in that spot where you wake up and you're in the center of the ring trying to figure out what happened. Was it all just a dream?
But again, it showcases his Bushido spirit, the fact that he is unwilling to capitulate. He would rather go to sleep.
I'd rather go to sleep. There's no reason for you to tap to a choke because the referee will wake you up and or stop it before you're hurt. That's how we run it in our school. You never tap. You always fight.
On a choke.
You know, he went to sleep, but I don't know if he was dreaming. This turned into a nightmare scenario for Maeda.
Yeah, a choke won't hurt you. It just puts you to sleep. Once the blood turns off, the brain turns off, you fall asleep. But the minute it comes back, you come right back to life. That's what's so important about the referee. And here's what Fernandez did. Beautiful double leg takedown. Sweep the legs right out of the way. Put him right in sort of a side position, and he took the back immediately. This is a beautiful takedown. Look at him pull the legs right out of the way. Sweep them. Automatically advancing. That's how he got the back slash side position there to end up in back. We talked about it being a tough position to choke from, but this one wasn't. You see him pulling his head down, the arm strap, good figure four.
I want to say thank you for Dream and Glory together. And I'm excited for